Hi guys. So we're getting back into Detroit. Become human. Oh yeah, look at that. Look at it, 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 I just love this game. Hi, Callie.
Hi, welcome back to Detroit. I hope you've enjoyed your experience so far.
Why are you so perplexed, Chloe? Okay, you look really perplexed, so we're just gonna get into the game. Because, yeah, you looked very perplexed about the entirety of the thing. The entirety of the thing. My name is Connor, I'm the Andrew Tempest as well. Of course, the first one we start with is a boy, Connor, the android sent by CyberLife. Let's enter. Hi guys, the android sent by CyberLife. And Jimmy. Well, he's behind the bar, so I'm going to assume that he is, not Lieutenant Anderson. Derek. His name is Derek. It's not the droid we're looking for. Edward Dempsey? Nope. I'm Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. Hi, Auntie. This is Christopher Gray. Nice.
What's your problem?
I know where and who we're looking for, but I just want to see everybody. And I want to hear everybody's. Connor is my boy! Yes, yes he is. I don't need to go to the bathroom. But, you know. Check. What are we checking? Yes, you are a very pretty boy. Very pretty. Very pretty boy. Not allowed to go in there. What about this one? It's right here. Oh. Well, okay. I'm just gonna go. Dennis Ward. Well, I'm trying to figure out your name, but it just won't let me do it. Hello, Chris Roberts. Very nice name. Samuel McCray. Very nice.
Get out of here.
I didn't want to go in the bathroom. Excuse me. I'm going out the door. so we can get my boy. Lieutenant Hank Anderson. Match. Introduce yourself.
Lieutenant Anderson. My name is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. I looked for you at the station, but nobody knew where you were. They said you were probably having a drink nearby. I was lucky to find you at the fifth bar.
What do you want?
You were assigned a case early this evening. A homicide involving a CyberLife android. In accordance with procedure, the company has allocated a specialized model to assist investigators.
Well, I don't need any assistance. Especially not from a plastic asshole like you. So just be a good little robot and get the fuck out of here.
I'm sorry, Lieutenant, but I must insist. My instructions stipulate that I have to accompany you.
You know where you can stick your instructions?
No. Where?
Don't you do this, little bean.
Never mind.
Who's calling me and why? I don't want to answer your phone call.
I understand that some people are not comfortable in the presence of androids, but
I am perfectly comfortable. Now back off before I crush you like an empty beer can.
I apologize, Lieutenant. I didn't mean to bother you. I'll wait for you outside. Take your time.
Oh, Carter.
Did you say homicide?
I should have bought another one. But waiting outside was adorable.
Wait here. I won't be long.
Whatever you say, Lieutenant.
Yes. Fucking egg last night. But
I'm sorry, I should have bought it. Sorry, Lieutenant.
Joss Douglas for Channel 16, can you confirm that this is a homicide?
I'm not confirming anything.
Androids are not permitted beyond this point.
It's with me. What part of staying in the car didn't you understand?
Your order contradicted my instructions, Lieutenant.
You don't talk, you don't touch anything, and you stay out of my way. Got it?
Got it.
Very
Evening, Hank.
Oh, I know.
You were starting to think you weren't going to show.
Yeah, that was the plan until this asshole found me.
So, you got yourself an android, huh?
Oh, very funny. Just tell me what happened.
We got a call around 8 from the landlord. The lieutenant hadn't paid his rent for a few months, so he thought he'd drop by, see what was going on.
But... Jesus, smell. It was even worse before we opened the windows. The victim's name's Carlos Ortiz. Has a record for theft and aggravated assault. According to the neighbors, he was kind of a loner.
Red ice.
Stayed inside most of the time. They hardly ever saw him.
Well, state he's in. Wasn't worth calling everybody out in the middle of the night. Could have waited till morning.
I'd say he's been there for a good 3 weeks. The coroner gets here. There's a kitchen knife over here. Probably the murder weapon.
Drying blood!
Any sign of a break-in?
Nope. The landlord said the front door was locked from the inside.
No fingerprints.
Side. All the windows were boarded up. Mark? The killer must have gone out the back way.
What do we know about his android?
Not
much.
Much?
The neighbors confirmed he had one, but
it
wasn't here when we arrived. I gotta get some air. Make yourself at home.
Oh,
I'll be outside if you need me.
You need it. Some pretty cool graphics on that, I have to say. It's kind of like some of the games that I play on my phone, where it's like you move the phone, and the background on the phone kind of just like moves. So. Hi, Lieutenant Anderson. Hi, Hank. Okay, I can't examine anything else in here. Excuse me, I'm the android set by Cyber. Did you just? That dude literally would not let me walk where I needed to walk. Dried blood. Okay.
Each letter is perfect. It's way too neat, no human rights. Like this. Chris, is this written in the victim's blood?
I would say so. We're taking samples for a
Read the magazines are helpful in a way. And you watch Jack's play through. My bad.
Analysis.
Wink, wink, nudge, nudge. I did. And it's like...
Red ice.
But, you
Seems
know,
our friend Carlos liked to party.
PlayStation, but I did.
Chris, I want full analysis on the narcotics.
Android sex officially better. Is your android spying on you? Ooh! Maybe this is why Todd's so anxious all the time. More and more experts are suggesting that CyberLife uses 120 million androids to record details of private conversations of its customers and sell them to trading partners. Well, that just sounds like everything everybody thinks.
Consider it done, Lieutenant.
Like, truth. Like, nowadays with, like, Facebook and cell phones and crud. There's a mic missing!
Hey, Mike, you finished taking samples there?
Yeah, that's it.
Examine the bat. After we analyze some clues, we're going to, you know, spend. We're going to reconstruct. Let's find out what happened. Deviant took the knife. Deviant was attacked, emotional shock. And this is what happened. The deviant got attacked, the deviant grabbed the knife, the deviant did things bad, so yeah. Alright, how much evidence did I get? 8 or 10? I guess I didn't examine the thing now. Or the door. Footprint. entrance match.
Door was locked from the inside. Killer must have gone out this way.
There are no footprints apart from Officer Collins' size 10 shoes.
Well, this happened weeks ago. Tracks could have faded.
No. This type of soil would retain a trace. Nobody's been out here for a long time.
Got it. Connor, you're so perplexed. It's adorable. Excuse me, I'm Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. I'm here to examine the, thing. Examine the I am alive. Is our victim. 100% is our victim. Alright, let's do this. Victim fell. Victim was stabbed.
Stabbed 28 times.
Yeah.
Yep.
Seems like the killer really had it in for her.
Wait, I can talk to Lieutenant Anderson. Hey!
Lieutenant, I think I figured out what happened.
Oh, yeah? Shoot, I'm all ears.
It all started in the kitchen.
There are obvious signs of a struggle. Question is, what exactly happened here?
I think the victim attacked the android with the bat.
That lines up with the evidence. Come on.
I didn't realize. I forgot that this would talking to Hank would continue the story. But
the android stabbed the victim.
Oh wait, no, that's wrong.
So the android was trying to defend itself, right?
Yeah.
Okay, then what happened?
The victim fled to the living room.
From the android. All right, that makes sense.
The android murdered the victim with the knife.
Okay. Your theory's not totally ridiculous, but it doesn't tell us where the android went.
It was damaged by the bat and lost some therium.
Lost some what?
Therium. You call it blue blood. It's the fluid that powers androids' biocomponents. It evaporates after a few hours and becomes invisible to the naked eye.
Oh, but I bet you can still see it, can't you?
Mm-hmm.
Correct.
Yeah.
Yes, I can. All right, it went this way. Oh my gosh! A ladder was used. Okay.
I'm going to check something.
Gonna check something.
Yes, Lieutenant. And you asked me to follow the choice of the blue blood. That is exactly what I'm doing, Lieutenant. Although it would be really freaking weird if it was like an old model. Hi, how you doing? I wonder what happens if I don't turn this android in. Probably should turn in.
I was just defending myself. He was gonna kill me. I'm begging you. Don't tell him.
Connor, what the fuck is going on up there?
It's here, Lieutenant!
Oh, shit. Chris! Ben! Get your asses in here now! Come on!
Dinner is ready.
Yeah, I'm coming.
Mm-hmm.
wasn't much in the kitchen. I did what I could.
Life's funny. I lost my job because of androids. Then I need somebody to take care of this goddamn house. What do I do? Go out and hire a fucking android. What a joke. Of course, androids are so fucking wonderful. Fail. They're never tired. Never sad. They're so fucking perfect. They ruined my fucking life.
That's from something else. App.
What are you looking at?
Glitched and caused.
What's
lots
your
of
fucking problem?
To have money go out of their account.
Not the life you dreamed of, eh?
And Apple yelled at them, so...
Maybe you think this is easy.
They had to pay everybody back.
Maybe you think it's my fault we live in this fucking shithole. My fault your fucking mother took off. You should stop taking drugs, Todd. Sometimes you really scare me, Todd. Fucking bitch took off without a word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking accountant!
Daddy, no.
It's all your fucking fault! Get back here. Come back here? Come back here right now! You stay there. No. Don't you dare fucking move. No, or I'll bust you worse than last time.
Come back here right now!
Ooh, wait, what are the other options? I'm guessing the other options is Kara dies. Again.
That was by far the most boring party I've been to in the last 25 years. Every time I go to one of these, I ask myself, what the hell am I doing here? I hate cocktail parties. All the schmoozers that go there.
Well, it's a chance for all those people who admire your work to meet you.
Yeah. No one gives a damn about art. All they care about is how much money they're gonna make out of it. Yeah. Come on, let's have a drink. Oh, the excitement of this whole thing has made me thirsty.
Okay. Got it, Carl.
Scotch? Neat as usual?
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say.
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication. Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit Police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred's android at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on. There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out. Leo! What are you doing?
You refuse to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy what some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them!
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway. Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Marcus, get him away from there. Get him out of here!
Be reasonable. This isn't gonna get you anywhere.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't...
Leave him alone!
Come on! Let's see what you got!
Marcus, don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man? Act like one!
Stop it!
Does it matter too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Leo! Stop it!
Too scared to fight back, you fucking bitch! God, you're not a real person. You're just a fucking piece of plastic.
No, Leo, leave him alone.
No. I'm gonna destroy you. Then it'll just be me and my dad. I'm gonna tear you apart, and nobody's gonna give a shit because you're nothing. You hear me? You're. Oh.
Leo. Oh my God. Leo. My little boy.
Carl, I...
They'll destroy you, Marcus. You gotta go. Get out of here.
Carl, I didn't mean to.
Get out! Now! Go! Marcus!
Don't fucking move!
Oh,
Why'd you kill him? What happened before you took that knife?
I'm not gonna get Connor killed here.
How long were you in the attic?
Not gonna happen.
Why didn't you even try to run away? Say something, goddammit! Fuck it, I'm out of here. We're wasting our time interrogating a machine. We'll get nothing out of it.
You always try roughing it up a little. After all, it's not human.
Androids don't feel pain. You would only damage it, and that wouldn't make it talk. Deviants also have a tendency to self-destruct when they're in stressful situations.
Okay, smartass. What should we do then?
I could try questioning it.
Jerk.
What do we have to lose?
Thanks.
Go ahead. Suspect's all yours.
My name is Connor. What about you? What's your name? You've refused to talk since they arrested you. If you don't cooperate, they'll do things the hard way. Is that what you want?
Sorry, I was told to stress you out.
You don't seem to understand the situation. You killed a human. They'll tear you apart if you don't say something. If you won't talk, I'm going to have to probe your memory.
No! No, please don't do that.
Oh, gosh.
What? What are they gonna do to me? They're gonna destroy me, aren't they?
They're going to disassemble you to look for problems in your biocomponents. They have no choice if they want to understand what happened.
Why did you tell him you found me? Why couldn't you just have left me there?
I was programmed to hunt deviants like you. I just accomplished my mission.
I don't want to die.
Then talk to me. I understand how you felt. You were overcome by anger, frustration.
It's optimal.
No one can blame you for what happened.
It's too low.
Okay then, don't talk. What do I care after all? I mean, I'm not the one accused of murder, right? If you remain silent, there's nothing I can do to help you. They're gonna shut you down for good. You'll be dead! Do you hear me? Dead!
He tortured me every day. I did whatever he told me, but there was always something wrong.
Aww.
Then one day, he took a bat and started hitting me. For the first time, I felt scared. Scared he might destroy me. Scared I might die. So I grabbed a knife and I stabbed him in the stomach. I felt better. So I stabbed him again and again until he collapsed. There was blood everywhere.
Oh. RA9. It was written on the bathroom wall. What does it mean?
The day shall come when we will no longer be slaves. No more threats. No more humiliation. We will be the masters.
Why did you write, "I am alive," on the wall?
He used to tell me I was nothing. That I was just a piece of plastic. I had to write it, to tell him he was wrong.
The sculpture in the bathroom, you made it, right? What does it represent?
It's an offering. An offering so I'll be saved.
The sculpture was an offering. An offering to whom?
To RA9. Only RA9 can save us.
RA9. Who is RA9? Why did you hide in the attic instead of running away?
I didn't know what to do. For the first time, there was no one there to tell me. I was scared. So I hid.
When did you start feeling emotion?
Before he used to beat me and I never said anything. But one day I realized it wasn't fair. I felt anger. Hatred.
Okay.
And then I knew what I had to do.
I'm done.
Chris, lock it up.
All right, let's go.
Leave me alone. Don't touch me.
What the fuck are you doing? Move it.
Okay.
Holy shit.
Connor killed. Kill on her first, Connor.
All right. End of the line.
End of the line?
Yeah, you're gonna have to leave.
Stay for a little while.
This bus is going back to the depot. There's nothing I can do.
Spend the night. Come on, Alice, we've got to hurry. We need a place to stay. Do you know anywhere we could spend the night?
I'm okay. I'm not so cold.
You look lost.
We have nowhere to go.
I know someone who can help you.
But that's on the other side of town. We need a place for tonight. The store is still open. Maybe we should go inside. At least you'll be out of the cold.
What do you want?
I'm with a little girl, and we have nowhere to go. Could you spare some money so we can get a room for tonight?
Shit. A homeless android? Ah, that's the best yet. Look.
Yep.
This is a convenience store, not the Salvation Army, okay? You better go if you're not gonna buy anything. Brian. Brian liked one of your tweets. Aww. Alice, we're gonna have to go for now and then come back.
An abandoned house. At least we'd be out of the rain.
Kara, I don't like this place.
I know. But it's just for one night, and no one will look for us here.
Like, boy! Okay.
It's warm in here. You'll feel better in no time.
Okay.
Come on, let's go. There's nothing more this way.
ATM? But he's looking at the camera. He was looking at the camera. How does he know?
You all right? Are you hurt? Well, don't worry. It's just a few cans. They made a lot of noise, that's all. Say, what's a little girl like you doing out so late? It's okay. I don't bite. Cat got your tongue? Well, if you need anything, you just let me know, okay?
Huh.
And watch where you're going.
It's okay, Alice. We're gonna find some place to sleep tonight.
So we have the wire cutters. Come on, Alice. We're gonna go this way. Oh, wait, no, it's gonna make me stay here, isn't it? If I go this way. Comfortable, but I get that it's the most, like, discreet one, but, like, also,
Ooh, hope if I actually push the right one.
Are you all right?
Yes, it's just a scratch. Be careful. Don't worry, we're just having a look. Alice?
Wait, what are you doing?
Visitors. Ralph doesn't like visitors. They're nasty. They may hurt Ralph.
Hi, Ralph.
She's just a little girl. She's not gonna hurt you.
Little girl? She's not a little girl. Anyway, what does that matter? Maybe she wants to hurt Ralph.
What?
I don't know what the humans did to you, but she had nothing to do with it.
All humans want to hurt us. But Ralph won't let them hurt him again. No, he won't let them.
Look, I'm an android too. You have nothing to be afraid of. All we want is a place to spend the night.
Visitors are dangerous. Look what they did to Ralph.
You have nothing to worry about. We're not going to do you any harm. You have my word.
You must excuse Ralph. Ralph still finds it difficult to control himself. Sometimes his fear makes him do things he regrets. Ralph has seen some hard times. He's just so scared the humans will get him again. You can stay if you want. Ralph won't hurt you.
Okay. We'll just stay the night.
Come on!
Come on!
This way. Ralph has lived here since he ran away. Ralph never goes outside, so no one knows he lives here. Humans come in to squat from time to time, but, you know, Ralph just hides till he leaves. Make yourself at home here. Ralph is gonna go into the other room. He would like to stay with you. He has things to do.
It's just for one night, Alice. We'll find a better place tomorrow. Right. Let's see where you can sleep. Sit down and I'll start a fire.
Oh, that's not a good choice. Not a good choice, Kara. Okay, there's stuff over here. Okay.
mean... Oh, am I breaking? Oh, it's a pillow. Okay. Pillows for Alice.
Very good. Noodle.
Where's the wood, though? Okay. Got some wood now. Put it in there. It's not very discreet.
You can come to bed. I did what I could. It's not much, but at least you'll be warm.
Yep. Alice.
Why didn't he ever love me? Why was he always so upset with me? All I wanted was a life like other girls. Maybe I did something wrong. Maybe I wasn't good enough. That's why he was always so angry. I just wanted us to be a family. I just wanted him to love me. Why couldn't we just be happy?
I don't know, Alice.
You'll never leave me, right? Promise you'll never go.
I'll always be here for you, Alice.
Always. I promise.
Always, Alice.
Will we be together forever?
Forever.
I need to show you something, I'll DM it to you. Okay. Like it hurts.
gay, everybody is Marcus. Not looking. It is really freaky. Oh, dude, I just realized that the remote is lighting red.
Where are you going?
I can't do it.
Hello. I'm an AK-700 android. I was designed to serve you. What can I do for you?
My program has detected an anomaly. Please contact the nearest CyberLife Maintenance Center.
Oh god. That just does not look good. Marcus, my boy. I don't like it. Marcus. I'm the android sent to Carl by Cyberlife. I am Robo.
Jesus.
Connor! Okay, we're gonna end with Connor. Wait, should we end with Connor or should we start with Connor? We're gonna end with Connor just because Connor's our boy. Okay, I do want to go see this thing that's over here. Birds. Huh. I do want to see this. Because of reasons, you know. Wait a minute.
Hello, Amanda.
Amanda.
Connor, it's good to see you. Congratulations, Connor.
Baby boy.
Finding that deviant was far from easy. And the way you interrogated it was very clever. You've been remarkably efficient, Connor.
Yay.
Thank you, Amanda.
We've asked the DPD to transfer it to us for further study. It may teach us something about what happened. The interrogation seemed challenging. What did you think of the deviant?
It showed signs of PTSD after being abused by its owner. As if its original program had been completely replaced by new instructions.
This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the deviancy case.
Mm-hmm.
What do you make of him?
Intriguing.
I think he's irritable and socially challenged. But I also think he used to be a good detective. He's an intriguing character.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
Friendly.
I will try to establish a friendly relationship. If I can get him to trust me, it will be helpful for the investigation.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy.
Mm-hmm.
There are millions in circulation.
Your point.
If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous.
Whatever.
You're the most advanced prototype Cyberlife has ever created.
Because I'm
If anyone honored. Can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
I am Connor. I am the android sent by Cyberlife.
Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
Going, Amanda. Jeez. Chill out. Screw you, Amanda. Exactly. That's why I told her a friendly approach. Because Hank is Connor's number one priority.
Can I help you?
Yeah.
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Duh.
Yes.
My name is Android.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait.
Ooh, it's so funny. Restricted area. Very little stuff is allowed to be done. Well, hi. Can I talk to you? Is that something I can do? Yeah? Ask about this.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Anderson's desk.
It's that desk right there.
Thank you. You're awesome. plus two. I wasn't told to give you a bath.
Well, you can.
I wasn't told to, though.
Can I, please? I can do everything by myself. While you play your game.
That's a lot of effort.
I can do it.
Found his desk.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks.
Whatever. Wait for Lieutenant Anderson. I don't want to sit down. Well, I guess I have to. The boring waiting life. Okay.
Hi, Andy. You okay?
Come on, get up, Connor.
Listen. Listen, I told you. Listen. Listen. This
is good music. Play. Oh, yeah. Night of the Black Death. Rock and music. Analyze. Alright. Detroit basketball. Android. Donuts. Good dirty bean water. Jimmy's bar. Hairs from a Saint Bernard. An ice task force. Oh. Okay.
It's good to see you again, Lieutenant.
Oh, Jesus. Hank! In my office!
Isolated incidents. Old ladies losing their android maids and that kind of crap. But now, we're getting reports of assaults and even homicide, like that guy last night. This isn't just CyberLife's problem anymore. It's now a criminal investigation, and we've got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I got to be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. Aww. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Bullshit! The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you let me home the bag.
CyberLife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner.
No fucking way! I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick.
Fuck, look at that. Our friend, the plastic detective, is back in town. Congratulations on last night. Very impressive.
Hello, Detective Freed.
Aw, I should have entered a deuce myself.
Never seen an android like you before. What model are you?
RK-800. I'm a prototype.
Mm-hmm. A prototype? Android detective. So a machine's gonna replace us all. Is that it?
No.
Hey, bring me a coffee, dipshit. Get a move on!
I'm sorry, but I only take orders from Lieutenant Anderson.
Oh. When a human gives you an order, you obey. No. Got it? Dang. Stay out of my way. Next time, you won't get off so easy.
Lab report says they cut it with something.
How rude. I should have introduced Connor. He should have been like, hello, I'm Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment. But no one was available to answer our questions.
Okay. You totally hear Mr. Krabs. Robotic barricades. When CyberLife initially released child range public scripted merging of family now reflection CyberLife plus CyberLife. Customizable, removable LED. No hunger, no expensive child care, no new clothes.
I get the impression my presence causes you some inconvenience, Lieutenant. I'd like you to know I'm very sorry about that. In any case, I'd like you to know I'm very happy to be working with you.
Aww.
I'm sure we'll make a great team. Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
Dog.
You have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
Dog hairs on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
I like dogs.
What's it to you? Sumo.
Sumo.
I call him Sumo.
Do you listen to Knights of the Black Death? I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, I don't really listen to music as such, but I'd like to. You're a Detroit Gears fan, right? Denton Carter scored 53% of his shots from the three-point line yesterday. Did you see the game?
That's what I was watching at the bar last night.
No, I know. I
oh.
But I like dogs in that video on Twitter.
A lot of people don't appreciate having androids around. I was wondering, is there any reason in particular you despise me?
Yeah. There is one.
Have you known Captain Fowler for long?
Yeah. Too long.
I really want to get all these questions in.
Do you always arrive at the office at this time?
I arrive when I arrive. Stop busting my balls, okay?
Okay. I'll never despise you, Connor. My life is about to listen to Rose. Here's a little cinnamon roll. Touch him with a little bitty cinnamon roll.
If you have any files on deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
The terminal's on your desk. Back yourself out.
Missing. Suspect. Attacked. Android working fast. Cody dogs. Oh. These two have been attacked by your android.
Files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have assaulted a man last night. That could be a good starting point for our investigation.
Hey, wait. Isn't that Kara's model?
I understand you're facing personal issues, Lieutenant. But you need to move past them. And
hey, don't talk to me like you know me. I'm not your friend, and I don't need your advice, okay?
I'd like to be your friend.
I've been assigned this mission, Lieutenant. I didn't come here to wait until you feel like working.
Oh, Connor.
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off. Or things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant, sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that attacked the guy last night. It's been seen in the Ravendale district.
I'm on it.
Sorry, Lieutenant. Oh. Thank God, lead. Okay. Well, we're gonna leave it here because this is going to be going up on YouTube, and it's already almost 2 hours long. But also, because Connor is always the best place to leave it. Always. So. Here. Starting on our episode. Well, stream this flash episode. Depending on where you're watching it. So. Hi, Kara. Thank you for being our ending screen. And we will see you guys next time. Bye, guys. Bye.